So let us come to the last fundamental right, which is your sixth right, which says right to constitutional remedies. Now this is your most important fundamental right. See, we have the government and the constitution have guaranteed you so many rights. We are saying if in any case your rights are violated, you can go to court. But this right says, right to constitutional remedies says, it basically ensures you that if any of your rights are violated, how you can issue a writ in the court, and then court will actually protect your rights. Article 32 of our constitution safeguards our fundamental rights by granting us the right to constitutional remedies. See, this is one important rights jo aapko actually protection deti hai agar koi bhi aapki fundamental right break hoti hai ya violate hoti hai. Violate is the correct term, break is not the correct term, it is just a simplified word. It is possible that the government may, on certain occasions, violate our fundamental rights. Our rights to constitutional remedies protect the government against such violation. Now see, it might happen that when government is making any new laws or bringing any new policies, ho sakta hai, wo kisi community ki group ko harm kare, or it can, you know, violate sentiments of people, or it is against the fundamental rights. So, in order to protect the citizens and in order to put control over government, that government aise koi bhi right nahi leke aa sakte, aisa koi bhi rule nahi leke aa sakte jo citizens ke fundamental rights ko violate karega, and in case wo lekar aate hain, so right to constitutional remedy will give justice. A citizen can file a lawsuit against the government in the High Court or in the Supreme Court, and if in case any such activity happens, like government is bringing any policies which is not in favor of your fundamental rights, so what can you do? You can go to either a High Court and a Supreme Court. The court possesses the power to uphold the fundamental rights of the citizens by using a writ or an order. Now, how will court give you protection? Court ke paas ek formula hota hai, that is, you can say writs or order. Now you can, how you will go to the court? There are certain writs mentioned in our constitution. Since it is about 8th class, that is why I am not going in detail, but I will simplify for you. We have certain writs, like for example, your any kind of fundamental rights has been violated, okay? Like for example, you go to any office, any government office, and they are not looking into your complaint and they are not solving your complaint. Now, what are government offices open for? To help the citizens. And if they are not helping the citizens, for example, you want to make an Aadhaar card, or you want to make your license for your any vehicle, and they are not looking into the matter. Okay, so you can go to the court. See, there has to be a period. That इतने पीरियड के अंदर आपका आधार कार्ड या आपका लाइसेंस कार्ड बन जाना चाहिए. बट इफ़ दे आर नॉट फॉलोइंग और सर्टन, दिस इज़ अबाउट डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ रिट्स. विद इन दैट रिट्स आई एम गिविंग यू वन एग्जाम्पल. सो यू कैन फाइल अ रिट इन द कोर्ट, इधर अ हाई कोर्ट और अ सुप्रीम कोर्ट, दैट दिस गवर्नमेंट ऑफिसर इज नॉट डूइंग हिज ड्यूटी वेल. ओके, लुकिंग इन टू दैट बेसिस एंड इंक्वायरी विल बी हेल्ड, एंड the court will actually issue an order against that person, and then government will have to look into the matter. Okay, so this is how your rights to constitutional remedy practice, and it protects your other fundamental rights. The backward sections and the people living below poverty line might not even be aware of the fundamental rights. Do you think the awareness about these rights is essential or in order to make them meaningful? Now they are saying since poor people are not educated enough, so they are not educated about their rights, or they are not aware about their basic fundamental rights. Fundamental rights is guaranteed to each and every person living in this country. Okay, उन्हें पता ही नहीं है उनकी fundamental rights क्या है. तो क्या आपको लगता है that we need to spread awareness and in order to make these rights meaningful? Do you think that we need to bring in more education and awareness? Yes, definitely. We need to promote more education and we need to bring in awareness so that backward people are aware of their fundamental rights.